Hello again, everyone. Jim Ross at the Oklahoma City Mirror. Glad you could be with us right here. This match is underway. As you see, the North American champion, Magnum T.A., going against Ted DiBiase. Carl Fergie, the third man in the ring. DiBiase looks as if he's loading that glove, his gloved right hand. And DiBiase has nailed Magnum T.A. Referee Carl Fergie, remember, ladies and gentlemen, this match is for the North American Heavyweight Championship. Ted DiBiase, one of the toughest men in all of wrestling. And he loaded that glove. Look at him going to that glove once again. DiBiase obviously putting something into those tights. He took it out of the glove. Magnum T.A. A deep laceration at the hands of Ted DiBiase. And your North American Heavyweight Champion is in deep, deep trouble here in Oklahoma City. Magnum T.A. goes out onto the floor. And DiBiase follows him right out. You see Magnum T.A.'s face, a crimson mask. And DiBiase and Carl Fergie. Fergie trying to get DiBiase to get back in the ring. This match is no disqualification, ladies and gentlemen. Both men signed the contracts. Remember, the championship is still on the line. And Magnum T.A. is in serious trouble at the hands of one of the toughest men in all of wrestling, Ted DiBiase. Magnum T.A. has turned back the challenge of some awesome competitors that have come for his North American Heavyweight Championship. And this classic battle here in Oklahoma City before several thousand people in the beautiful Myriad. High elevation. And frankly, I don't know how much more Magnum T.A. can take, because he has suffered at the hands of the methodical Ted DiBiase, and DiBiase with a very confident look on his face. There's that power slam. A perfectly executed power slam by Ted DiBiase. And we may well see a new North American heavyweight champion being crowned right here. It looks as if DiBiase is going for that figure four leg lock. DiBiase weakening the leg with a spinning toe hold. And over the top goes DiBiase. Magnum T.A. kicked him off over the top rope with Ted DiBiase. Referee Carl Fergie counting. Both men have a 10 count. Magnum T.A. to get to his feet. DiBiase to get back into the ring. DiBiase obviously slowed now that he has gone out to that concrete floor, and now DiBiase climbing up to the top. Remember, this is no disqualification. And Magnum T.A. with a right hand deep to the solar plexus. And DiBiase now, the champion, in great condition, coming back against DiBiase, and they're standing fighting right hands and lefts. Magnum T.A. with a great drop kick, and he's fired up and ready to go. Belly-to-belly suplex. Magnum T.A. wraps the leg. One, two, three, the winner of the match. And still North American heavyweight champion, Magnum T.A. This is Jim Ross from Oklahoma City's Myriad Center.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Wrestling fans, the Oklahoma City Myriad is the site. Terry Taylor versus Mike Gallagher. Ring introductions are complete. As Terry Taylor warms up, you can hear the fans rumbling in the background. Terry Taylor's their favorite. Referee Ronnie West. This is a videotape replay of a match that took place in Oklahoma City on the 5th of October in 1984. Terry Taylor had just come back to the Mid-South after an illness, but he came back in good shape and he's been steadily improving ever since through his battles with Kamala, his acquisition of the North American title and the TV title simultaneously have led most wrestling experts to believe that he's one of the hottest wrestlers in the country, and he's hot on the trail of Nature Boy Ric Flair and that NWA World's Heavyweight title. Terry Taylor has confided in me before that the NWA World's title has always been one of his biggest goals in professional wrestling. Many wrestling experts tend to believe that Terry Taylor, if he gets Ric Flair in a match and things are going his way, that we could see a new world champion. And I'll tell you, it couldn't happen to a better guy, a better athlete than Terry Taylor. Ronnie West checking that hair there. Mike Gallagher with a headlock, but it's going to take a lot more than a headlock to handle Terry Taylor. Terry Taylor reversing out with that top wrist lock. Terry Taylor giving Gallagher a little bit of his own medicine there. And Ronnie still checking to make sure that headlock is still within the legal parameters. A great match for you so far. If you stay tuned, we'll see Dr. Death against Nikolai Volkov in a match where, from about a year ago, Dr. Death probably in not near as good of a shape as he is now. But we'll see how he fares against the big Russian later on. Both men up to their feet. Terry Taylor fires Gallagher off. Gallagher hits him with a hard shoulder smash. Taylor with a hip toss. And now Taylor with the headlock. Gallagher uses the hair there. And Ronnie West checking him. Ronnie West has been put out of refereeing. If you've seen Power Professional Wrestling, you saw what happened to him in a recent show where the nightmare pile-drived him. He suffered extensive upper spinal column damage, and I'm sorry to say that he won't be able to referee anymore. It's a loss to the profession, but at least Ronnie has still got his life to look forward to. He's a terrific individual. Gallagher with the leg scissors there on the head of Terry Taylor. Terry Taylor has been learning and perfecting, as we've said on Power Professional Wrestling, the figure four leg lock. the hold that is, in many people's opinion, has made Ric Flair the NWA World's Champion. And whoa! Taylor with hard right crosses. He's getting fed up with Gallagher bending the rules. Snap mare. Taylor fires him into the ropes. Drop kick. But Gallagher just went spaghetti-legged on that one. Taylor caught him with a full impact of that drop kick. Forearm! That patented forearm from Terry Taylor and Ronnie West with the three count. Terry Taylor, the winner of the match. You can hear the fans behind him as Terry Taylor gets another victory. Let's go back to Jim.